Hi, humanoid gigabytes! I'm Paulina Lara, Pauliphysics, and today I have a special video for travelers. If you are into traveling, it's very likely that you have heard about Couchsurfing, the way to travel for free or stay in places for free. And I'm using these quotation marks because it is true, it's almost free, but it's not only about that. Today I want to share with you 5 points to enjoy this experience, to actually connect with cool travelers around the world and make the most of your experience as a couch surfer. I joined this community around 5 years ago where I was studying, and it was amazing to meet wonderful people and experience cool things with locals. First of all, you should check your profile. Well, complete it. Now, the platform is actually asking you to verify, to make a payment, to connect all your social accounts and a lot of things in order to make it more believable, in order to let other people know that you exist, that you're a nice person, and that you are a genuine traveler. So my advice is do as much as is needed. Before, you didn't have to pay. I think now it's kind of compulsory. But if you think it's something that it might help, go for it. I think it's not that much. Now, my advice in terms of profile, paying or not paying, is complete it as much as you can. What do you like? What you don't like? What are cool things you have done? What is your interest in traveling and travelers around the world? In any case, what can you share with others if they would host you? So this is very nice. Make it genuine. Please do not put like your home address or like all your details. We don't have to know everything and make it unsafe, but definitely consider completing a very believable and cool profile. My second advice is not to public your trip plans. There is this possibility where you can say, oh, I'm gonna be traveling to Malaysia for 2 weeks in blah, 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 from 15th to the 25th. So don't do that. I think, okay, you can do that, but do not ask for a couch there. Because it's true, people might approach you and say, oh, you can stay with me. Great, come and stay in my place. But the reality is that you don't really know if this person is the person you want to stay with. My advice is publish that to meet people, to go to get-togethers, meetups and everything, but do not ask for a couch publicly. My third advice is look for your best match. So here's what I'm talking about, where you need to find who is the person that you want to spend time with. This is very important, because what if you are a vegetarian and then you find someone that only eats meat and won't let you out unless you finish a hamburger? It's very important that you check the profile, read the references, check what other surfers have said about this person. And if you actually think that this is a person that you might click with, then yes, totally try to get a couch with them. And this leads to my fourth tip, which is ask nicely. Once you're realize that this is the person that you want to spend time with, that this is the person that you are actually gonna enjoy your traveling and meeting other people, or even looking at the place, sightseeing, and every other local activities that you can share with, then you have to be very smart and say, why is it important for you to stay with them? What I used to like when I was opening my couch was, what are your travel plans? How long do you want to stay? And why am I supposed to host you? So very important is that you see if there's a connection there and actually address that, because that's very nice. If you find someone that loves the same music that you do, address that, because you will very likely enjoy spending good evenings sharing this nice music. So definitely check that. Travel plans, how long do you want to stay, which I normally recommend 2 to 3 days, depending on how it goes, then you can extend. And definitely say, what would they gain by meeting you, by meeting this amazing person? Let's sum up what we've seen so far. Profile. Your profile has to be honest, legit, and complete. Do not make public your travel plans unless you want to meet up. Not looking for a couch. Look for your best match and ask nicely. Let's say you already found the perfect person, you spend an amazing time with them, you actually saw great things that normally as a tourist you wouldn't see. So what's next? You should leave a reference. This is maybe one of the most important things about this community. The Couchsurfing community trusts in people. In general, what we need from you is to tell others how it was to spend some time with this person. If it was a great reference, make it worth. Say why it was great, say that you're willing to actually share again, and just let others know how amazing this person was. If you were not that lucky and you had a very bad experience, let's say that you were the vegetarian who actually had to eat the hamburger, you should also say that, because other people need to know and be aware of this person. And actually, that will help also the community to ban a profile that is not secure. So please, always, always leave a reference. As I told you, my dear human idealites, I was very happy when I was traveling or I was hosting. Now my situation is a bit different, so I'm not doing it anymore. But I'm trying to actually meet up with some people, because it's always nice to meet other travelers in your city. If you live in one or you're traveling to one and you want to meet up with cool people and cool travelers, always check the Couchsurfing community first. This is my personal experience, and I can tell you that it's an amazing network. It is so cool to find wonderful people with amazing and fascinating stories. So definitely, I would always recommend it. Now, the mission of this platform is to put travelers together and make a better world through traveling. So the reality is that if your mission is not that, and if you want to date, or if you want to just get a place for cheap, then maybe this is not the place for you. On the other hand, there are surfers that are actually into this, into either dating or only offering a couch without spending any time, without sharing. So if that's the case, also check that. So I would always say that, as everything in the world, there are colors, there are choices, there are tastes, and you can always look for someone that is more or less close to what you want. This is my Couchsurfing experience, so my dear humanoidigabyte, if you're traveling and if you want to join the Couchsurfing community, use it respectfully. Try to be as respectful as you can, always, mindful, open. And if you want to really explore this thing, I would recommend to follow my 5 tips. Are you a traveler and you're trying to find cheap accommodation? Let me know in the comments, what are your thoughts? What do you do? How do you do it? And if you've ever used Couchsurfing, what was your experience as well? I am Paulina Lara, Pauliphysics, and my dear human gigabyte, I see you next week. Tschüss!